Good morning, and thank you, Bill. That was wonderful. Thank you so much. And good morning, everyone. Welcome to Unity of Orange County. We're so glad that you are here today. And if you're tuning in on YouTube, we're glad that you tuned in. Before we get started, I like to affirm our vision and mission statement. Our vision statement, centered in divine love, we joyfully co-create a world that works for all. And our mission statement, to awaken, inspire, and transform lives. And before I get to announcements, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank those that help make this service possible. We have Bill on piano, Tom on audio, Waverly is streaming, John on camera. Today, Shanice will read the daily word and guide us through our meditation. And Reverend Arlene is back. Yay. And her talk today will be Back to Community in Unity. Looking forward to that. There will be a town hall meeting today at 11 a.m. and it will be live and on Zoom. And our Zoom number is 818-8859-3747. I hope all of you will be there. This is your spiritual community, and we would love your input. Your board has been working very hard this past year and a half and trying to keep everything going, making sure that we have things for you to do and keep you connected. But we need to hear from you and hear to see what you want to have done here. So be there. Our classes are still ongoing. We have our book discussion group, The Intuitive Way by Penny Pierce. And this is the definitive guide to increasing awareness. A renowned intuitive and visionary shows you how to do what you need to know just when you need to know it. And that is on Wednesdays from 6:30 to 8. And we have our gratitude circle, which will meet on June the 27th at 11:45. And there is a new class in July. It's called Spiritual Economics by Eric Butterworth. Begins on Tuesday, July the 6th from 6:30 to 7:30. And this is a powerful book that will change the way you look at prosperity, your relationship to money, and how spirituality relates to it. And it really is a powerful book. So I hope that you will join in on that. And that will be on Zoom as well. Sunday, July the 12th at 11:30, we will be having a fundraiser. And this is going to be by Dr. Laura. And she is a speaker, author, artist, angelic healer, and intuitive life coach. And she helps people transform their lives, connect with their innate talents and abilities, and move into alignment with their soul's authentic path. And the fundraiser will be on Messages from the Angelic Realm. So prepare yourself to experience profound healing in mind, body, and spirit, as Dr. Laura will take you on a unique journey within your soul to help you heal traumas, repair DNA, and remember your magnificence. There will also be a collective and personal messages from the angelic realm for the participants. So that sounds really fabulous. So be sure that you mark your calendar for Sunday, July 12th at 11:30. Okay, so now I'd like to invite Shanice to read our daily word.
Good morning. Daily word for today, Sunday, June 6, 2021, is healing. My thoughts, words, and actions affirm divine life. My thoughts, words, and actions affirm divine life. Today, I give thanks for the constant activity of divine healing life, especially when my body is experiencing illness. To bolster my awareness of my capacity for healing, I place my attention on my inherent wholeness. I affirm life in my thoughts, my words, and my actions as I care for my body and meet its needs. My faith assures me that illness is not the truth of me, nor is it my enduring reality. Through my actions, I am affirming wholeness as my true nature and encouraging my healing. Even when I am not facing illness, I greet each day by blessing my body, affirming my wholeness, and the ongoing activity of divine life in every organ and every cell. I give thanks for the gift of divine life by giving thanks for my healing and living joyously. From Luke chapter 8, verse 48, he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you whole. Go in peace." Now I invite you, as we prepare for the sacred time of meditation, the sacred time of visitation, sacred time of being with the One, in the One, invite you to relax, get comfy right where you are, get kindful to the moment that's right here before you, kindful to the thoughts that will float in and out like clouds. Just become friendly with yourself, with your awareness, with your present moment right now. If your eyes aren't already gently closed, I invite you to do so, or just soften your gaze. All we need to do is tune in. Open the door of your heart. Invite the Beloved in. A beautiful guest waits to inhabit your awareness and embody your being. The One seeks to live life through you only as you can do. So resting in the silence, resting in the sunlight of the Spirit, we're going to bathe ourselves in our true eternal light. We're going to let it fill every cell of our being, heal every limiting thought or belief. There's nothing we need. We are whole in this light of Spirit. Feel this brilliance, this white, effervescent light pouring in from all around you, like sunlight sparkling on water. We invite it in. We say, "Come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit, come. Activate the Christ in me. Shine your light through me. Let me be the way your love flows into the world." And just for now, I will not worry. Just for now, I will spend this moment with you, letting go, letting you take the lead as I dance with you in the silence of the Spirit. So it is.
Thank you so much, Bill. That was great. Well, welcome. Welcome to Unity of Orange County. So glad you're here. So, you know, we're at this point right now regarding the pandemic where we know things are about to change. We're not quite sure what. People keep throwing dates out, June 5th, June 15th, whatever. But we know that things are going to change, which means they're going to change for us here because we've been used to doing things. You know, we've adjusted to the rules and the regulations. But now we know things are going to change. And so it's a good opportunity for us to look at where we are now and where we want to go. Because things are going to change. And it's a good opportunity for us to see how we as a spiritual community want to go from here. It's kind of like a rebirth. It's kind of like this rebirth because we've been like in hibernation, asleep for a year and a half. And now we get to awaken and we got to think about what we want to look like when we awaken to this new life. So we're going to be looking at how we can use the principles that we've been looking at for the last few weeks and how we can use it for us as a community. Because although we as individuals do things like affirmations and prayer and meditation and we vision and do all of that, we as a group is also like an individual. It's like, and we have the same kind of consciousness as we do as individuals. There's the individual consciousness and there's the group consciousness. And there's something really powerful about the group consciousness. You know, Jesus said, when two or more are gathered, there I am in the midst. If you pray by yourself, that is powerful. But if you pray with someone else or with a group of people, it is off the chart as far as the power goes. And so we need to look at that. How do we come together with prayer and affirmations and decide where we want to go from here? So I have to kind of apologize because I had asked for people to send me visions. And I didn't really explain what I was looking for because I guess I really didn't know what I was looking for, or I got words all mixed up. You know, we have a vision statement, and whether you like it or not, we got that vision statement 5 years ago, and we're going to look at redoing our vision statement and our mission statement because we're a different church than we were when these things came in. And a lot of people sent me some great ideas about things that we could do. But what I was talking about is not what can we do, but what can we hold in our consciousness, in our prayer time, as to what we want to be as a spiritual community. In other words, what can we affirm as a community so that everybody is kind of affirming the same thing in their prayer time? You know, when you pray for this church, what is it that you pray for? Or how do you see this church? And so we're going to look at that at the town hall meeting, and we're going to come up with that. But the reason it's so important, so we were talking a few weeks ago about the power of the thought. You know, we have this mind, which is attached to God mind, and through that we have these thoughts. And our thoughts determine our life. And then the words we speak give even more power to the thoughts. So it is our thoughts and the words we speak. That is why affirmations are so important. Something happens when things get affirmed. So Laura, who's coming in July, I have to say, I've never been one to believe in anybody doing anything when it comes to telling me my future, angels, whatever. I've just been this one of these people. I figure, you know, I'm going to trust God's will. When it happens, I'll find out about it, you know. But I won a session with Lara 2 years ago at the Christmas. And so I went thinking, okay, I don't know what this is, but whatever. You know, I won it. It's free. And I'll do anything if it's free. Anyway, so I meet her, and I have to tell you, I was blown away. Blown away. It was nothing what I suspected. It wasn't someone, you know, predicting the future for me or whatever. It was someone going into this state and affirming for me what was mine to do, and gave me some insight and some answers to some things that I had without telling me. In other words, she didn't say, you do this and you do that. But when I left there, I had this knowing. I had this unbelievable knowing about what was mine to do next without her telling me, just through this. So whether you believe in this kind of stuff or not, I'm telling you, it's really amazing. So anyway, so we have this stuff and we have these thoughts and we have these words, and there's a lot of power to that. And then when you come together with those words and you pray together, amazing things happen. And so I know I've probably told this story before, but when my daughter-in-law was pregnant with my granddaughter, there was a questionable pregnancy. And they thought that the child was going to be born with some serious brain damage. And so they said to her, they said, the child's brain is getting too big. The head is getting too big. If it gets over a certain amount, we're going to have to do an emergency cesarean session. So I was just, everyone was fraught. So I went to my Unity Church and I told them what was going on. And I asked them to pray. I asked them to pray. So a week later comes and they schedule my daughter-in-law for an emergency C-section, which meant that the baby's brain was getting too big. And so they did it, and my granddaughter was born perfectly healthy with a normal size head. Everything was fine, and it was just amazing. So my son, who's an atheist, you know, it doesn't believe in anything. I said to him, well, I know you don't believe in prayer, but everybody in my church was praying. And I know you don't think it means anything, but I believe that prayer works. And he said, well, I don't believe in prayer as far as there's some God in heaven doing what you ask it to do. But I believe if enough minds come together with one thought, that that creates this ripple in the universe and things change. And I thought, well, I believe the same thing. What do you think group prayer is about? You know, it's not about getting some God to change its mind. It's about creating a shift in the universe because you have all these thoughts going the same way. So interesting, years later, my granddaughter is 10 or 11. She's going through being brought up in a atheist house. She's having some questions about faith. And so I suggested to my daughter-in-law that she take her to a church. So she actually took her to the church I used to belong to in Miami. Well, when they found out that that was the girl that they had prayed for like 10 years ago, they went nuts over her. They were like, oh my God, look at you in all of this, because there was the evidence of their prayer. So something happens when we come together and pray. And something happens when we come together and we all have the like mind, because there's something powerful. So there was a man years ago in England by the name of George Mueller, and he had a home where he had boys who were homeless, and he believed that God would take care of all their needs. And so one day it was time for dinner and there was no food to feed the boys. And so one of his associates came to him and said, you know, it's time for dinner and there is no food. And George said, call the boys, tell them to get ready for dinner, tell them to wash up and do what they have to do. And he said, but there is no food. And George says, just get them ready. So he gets the boys ready and everything else, and he brings them down to the table. And he says to George, he goes, there's still no food. And George says, have them sit at the table and say grace. Because he just was so sure that God was going to provide for these boys. So the boys sit around the table and they say grace. And just then, a truck pulls up. Somebody had brought this truck filled with food to donate to feed these boys. And it was such an amazing thing. And then George did something really interesting. He fired the guy who doubted. He fired the guy who doubted because it was so important. He felt that everybody who worked for him believed and knew that God was the source. And you know, Joel Osteen was that way. When he was forming his church, if you did not believe that this was going to happen, if you did not believe that they were going to have this big stadium and it was going to be filled with people, you were not on his team. So something happens when we come together, and it's important for this church to come together. It's important that we're all thinking the same thing. If some people are thinking, oh, it's never going to happen, it can't happen, blah, 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 guess what? It's not going to happen. We have to come together like a team, because when a team comes together, and in a way we are a team, miracles happen. So I was trying to think of something that showed what the miracle that happens when people come together of like mind in a purpose, a group purpose, as opposed to individual purpose. And, you know, I'm a big movie buff. I've watched a lot of movies. I've watched a lot of sports movies. I mean, I've watched a lot of sports movies because I think that sports movies have an amazing message. But there was none that I've ever watched that was like the story that's told in the movie The Miracle, which is about the U.S. hockey team in 1980 that won the World Olympics. Now, you have to understand that up to 1980, the U.S. hockey team was losers. I mean, they really couldn't get their stuff together. They were amateurs, and the Russians were like gods as far as hockey teams go. No one could beat them. And so the Olympic team hires Herb Brooks to be the coach. And he was a college coach. And he gets his team together. They're all young. They're all like 20, 21. They play for different teams and everything. And they come together. And initially, they're all kind of playing their own game. You know, they're all playing like, because they're used to being stars on their team. And so they're playing individually. And he takes this team and he brings them together. And he actually makes himself the common scapegoat. In other words, he becomes the thing they all hate because he's so tough on them. But it brings them together. And he takes this team of 20 young boys who have nothing in common other than the fact they like to play hockey. And he forms them into a team. A team, and he says in one scene, he tells them, he says, it's not the name on your back, but it's the name on your front, which is the USA. And so they get through the Olympics, and they get to a semifinal, and they now have to play the Russians. Now, they have been beaten by the Russians in pregame stuff, and they have been embarrassed by them, and they have just been knocked over. And he tells them before the game, he says, this is your day. This is your time. And this is exactly how this happened in 1980 with the USA team and the Russians. I just want to say that was 1980, and the Cold War was at its top. And the Russians were really, you know, our arch enemy. And these young men from 20 different backgrounds came together and found a commonality and use that commonality to come together as a team. And not only did they win, but they changed the whole nation. The whole nation began to celebrate and have hope and begin to believe that there is something possible, that this Cold War and these Russians and all this stuff, that we could pursue and believe and continue and grow and win and whatever. They gave us hope. They gave the country hope and they helped the country believe. When we come together as a group, there is nothing that cannot be accomplished. This sanctuary can be full, stuffed. People could be outside listening to it because there's not enough room. The music can be filling this place up. We would have children, lots of children. And financially, we will have no problems whatsoever. And we will have all the volunteers and all the energy and all the enthusiasm. And we won't have one or two classes. We'll have many classes. There's nothing that we cannot do. But we have to decide this is our opportunity to start again. This is our opportunity to create a church we want to have. Forget what we were before. This is a new time. This is a new beginning. And anything is possible, but we have to come together. We have to come together as a team with one purpose, one idea, one vision, one affirmation, and then anything is possible. George Mueller understood that. You know, I know that, although I may sometimes forget it. But I know that is true. So I invite you to close your eyes right now. And I want you to look into your hearts and ask yourself, what do you visualize this church to be, say, a year from now? Know that nothing is impossible, because with God, all things are possible. There is no dream too big. For God. God performs. God does. The universe gives us what it is that we affirm we already have. There is no room for any thoughts of fear, lack, limitation, disbelief. None of that. The universe responds to positive thoughts, to positive words, to know that it is possible. All things are possible. This is a new beginning, and we get to choose where we're going to go with this. We get to choose what we will become. And so I invite you to also come to the meeting. You are what is going to help build this church to be the thriving, prosperous, spirit-led community that will attract whatever it needs to do whatever needs to be done. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you so much, Bill. That was awesome. And thank you, Reverend Arlene. Looking forward to the town hall meeting today. Thank you so much. Here at Unity, we have five basic principles that we believe in. So let us recite these together. One, God is all good and active in everything, everywhere. Two, I am naturally good because God's divinity is in me and in everyone. Three, I create my experiences by what I choose to think and what I feel and believe. Four, through affirmative prayer and meditation, I connect with God and bring out the good in my life. And five, I do and give my best by living the truth that I know I make a difference. And we also believe in the principle of giving and receiving. And we want to thank you for donating to our spiritual community. Our church is supported by donations. And we are particularly dependent right now on donations since we don't have income from rental or classes. And remember, all your donations are tax deductible. So we have several ways that you can donate. You can visit our website and click on the donate button, and you can donate there. You can text a donation to 77977 and type Unity of OC Give in the message. Of course, you can mail a check to Unity of Orange County at 23181 Verdugo Drive, Suite 103B in Laguna Hills. Or if you're here today, you can leave your gifts in the box as you exit the sanctuary. Your committed contribution allows Unity of Orange County to more efficiently manage the daily operations supporting our Sunday service, ministries, administration, and operations. So all of your donations are greatly, greatly appreciated. So if you would please put your hands together and let us have our affirmation prayer. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And we always give in love. And so now let us close our service with our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Yay, God. Thank you. We'll see you in a few minutes, we hope, and have a wonderful week.